lock down the airwaves. Give God the praise right now. Forever will float on a white cloud. Gonna lock down the airwaves. Give God the praise right now. Forever will float on a white cloud.
This message is going out to all the believers. Yes, the believers who sit alongside those Christians in those Christian so-called synagogues, a churches on Sunday morning. Now, this is the difference between a believer and a Christian. Now, the Christians, they don't question anything. They just take it for granted that the man behind the pulpit knows everything. But a believer, well, now that's a dough new ball of wax. He knows. He studies the Bible. He don't just read the Bible. He don't just read it and take it at its face value. But he studies to show thyself approved unto God. See, that's a true believer. He's one that's been born again and baptized in the ways of the living God. See, everybody else follows. They're just followers and they're not believers. Last call for the believers right now. This is what we're going out to. But I'm going to talk to you Christians as well. See, you think that you have it going on. You think that because you're in a so-called church of maybe 500 or 20,000 or 2,000 or 5,000 that God has to be in the midst. Well, let me tell you something. See, when Jesus was on the earth, when Yahshua was on the earth, he fed 5,000. And he talked to 5,000. But here's the difference about you Christians. You see, you think you have to stand in front of a pulpit. I've heard him say that everywhere he went, he had a pulpit. But let me tell you, if you read in Matthew 5, it'll tell you that and when he was set, and when he sat down, he began to preach to them. But he found out as he preached to them that they didn't understand what he's talking about, so he had to turn around and teach them. How can you preach something that people don't know? You got to teach them. And see, that's where the believers. But here's the other thing, believers. Last call, believers. For so long, God has allowed the believers to sit in there with you, hoping that you would find out and follow their lead. But oh no, you got something else sitting right beside you. You follow their lead. You got those that believe in the Easter Star. You got those that in the Masonic balls. They got they walk around with their big old rings and they do all kinds of hidden things and they think you never say a word. But to a believer, you want to jump on him when he asks a question about this or that. Ain't that right, pastors? Ain't that right, Reverend Doctors? Ain't that right, bishops? Wow. Isn't a shame, because he said those many come to take the kingdom by force, believers. But you know, this is how you shall know that ye are a true believer, because the kingdom lives within you. In Luke 17:21, if you always had that thought, if you always had a question in your hearts, you ain't no Christian, brother. You a believer. This is the last call for the believers to stand up. Leave everything on the pew. Don't even hold your hand up with the one finger that's two fingers. Just exit the building, because that building is dead. You keep hearing them say, when you hear them say that the Holy Ghost, we want it to come on down, but guess what? You know that the Holy Ghost lives within inside of you. Come on, believers. Time to leave. Last call. Leave now or forever hold your peace.
You think that's air you're breathing now?